Today I want to tell you something very interesting and very, very important. Last week I had gone to the hospital. My friend's husband was admitted over there. The last I had seen him was almost 12 to 15 years back. I always remembered him as a very energetic, enthusiastic, jovial, hyperactive person. He and his wife have always been a very special couple to us friends. We labeled them a very naughty couple. My friend used to tell us a lot of stories about her husband and how he's completely into her, how they have a very active married life, how they are completely into each other. That special way of communication, eye-to-eye contact, knowing what each other wants. Very, very special couple. And then this. He's in the hospital now. Diagnosis: blood cancer, third stage. When I went to see him, I saw him lying on that bed with so many tubes and wires connected all over his body, a screen there showing his heartbeats. I could not believe that he's the same person. I spoke to him for 10 minutes. At first I asked him, does he even recognize me? I was seeing him after a very, very long time. So I asked him. I did not expect a response. I did not even expect him to talk to me, because that particular stage was a stage when doctor had said that anything could happen to him. Critical 24 hours, critical days. So I was not expecting to have any kind of conversation with him. I was very jittery talking to him. But still, I had to say something. So I asked him that, do you recognize me? Aapko pata hai ki main kaun hu? He said, ha, of course I know you. You came to our house. He recalled and told me that the position where I was sitting when I had gone to their house, the place on their sofa where I was sitting, how electricity had gone at that time, and we had lighted up the candles and we had a kind of a candlelight dinner that evening. He remembered all those things. It was absolutely amazing. A person who is fighting a battle of life and death is recalling all those things and narrating it to me. The very next moment, my entire perspective changed. All that sympathy that I had for him changed, and it was now like, wow, I'm talking to someone who's perfectly alright. I asked him, come on, this is not the place you're supposed to be lying down. I want to come to your home again. Let's have that candlelight dinner again. Let the medicines do their job, but you do your job, and that is fight with it. Let not cancer win you. What will happen, what will not happen, is destiny. But seeing that spirit in him, I could not believe that this is a person who is so sick. I had a 10-minute conversation with him, and all my tiredness for the past 2 days that I was having, was not well, everything disappeared. Seeing this spirited person. Constantly, continuously, people keep coming, asking for him. Even those people whom she has not directly told, even they were coming and seeing him. His school friends, his college friends, his office friends, the building friends, people who even remotely know him are coming and seeing him. She told me that this was because he has always been connected to every person whom he meets, caring for them, going to their houses, connecting with them, concerned about them, asking them how they were, inviting people to their houses. So he was always a people's person. At the same time, he was also a family person. I heard silently everything that she told me. I came back home, and that night, everything that happened in that evening set me thinking. Number one, value of life. Those who are watching this video, you tell me, do you actually realize the value of your life? We take our breathing for granted. We take our hands for granted. We take our eyes for granted. We take our entire body. We take our health for granted. Ask those people who are not so healthy, who are sick, who do not have as many number of days of life, and all they wish is few more days of life, few more days to fulfill all those unfulfilled desires, purposes. So lesson number one, value your existence, value your life. Stop grumbling about small things. Stop grumbling about not getting what you want. Start valuing what you have. And the biggest gift that we can ever have is our own lives. We are alive. We are alive to see the beauty of this world. Gift of life. Adding to this, value others' lives. Say what you want to say. Do what you want to do. Go and say sorry to that person to whom you have done something wrong. Go and hug your family members. Go and hug your friends. Go and hug someone who is getting angry at you. Go spread love. Go spread happiness. Go spread cheer. We live only once. Only once. And that too, we do not know what is our expiry date. Lesson number two. When you see a sick person, empathize. Be with the person. You may not be able to cure. You may not have any kind of a magical cure. But being for that person, being there to listen to that person, talk to that person, your physical presence matters. In our fast-paced life, we are so busy working, living, that we forget all those who are around us. There are so many who need us, but who may not tell us. Go and appreciate the people who are around you, who are there for you. Attend to the sick. Attend to those who are alone. Attend to those who are isolated. They need you. And that can even become the purpose of your life. How many times you must have felt that the life is so meaningless. No purpose to my life. It's so monotonous. Every day morning I get up, I go to work, and then I come back and I go to sleep. Isn't it? Who is going to find a purpose for your life? Who is going to make your life different? Who is going to come and tell you, come on, get up. This is the purpose of your life. You have to find out the purpose of your life. And you don't need to be saints for that. You don't need to have big purposes. Small purposes. Being happy and making others happy. Valuing oneself and valuing others. As simple as that. Thirdly, maintain relationships. We are human beings. we live in a society. We need each other. We cannot live isolated from the rest of the society. So maintain relationships, build relationships, nurture relationships. Never have that pride inside you that someone is too insignificant for you to be even close to or even be around in the vicinity of that person. Value relationships, build relationships, nurture relationships. Let us truly with all our heart say, life is beautiful. Just to summarize whatever we talked today, number one, value your life. Value every breath you take. Value your existence and value existence of those around you. Number two, build relationships, maintain relationships, nurture relationships. We need each other. We cannot exist all alone in this society. We need love, we need care, we need compassion. Value relationships. Have a purpose in life. Keep having purposes in life. No need to be a saint to have big purposes. No need to have grand plans, micro plans, mini plans. Have purpose every day. Let every single day of your life be purposeful. Let there be meaning in your life. Let there be purpose in your life. Life is beautiful. Those 10 minutes with that person made me value my life, made me value my time, made me value my relationships, made me realize the many purposes of my life that I need to attain, achieve, and fulfill. Have a great life and have a great day. Have a great purpose in your life. Until my next video, stay blessed and stay loved. Stay healthy.